Everyone, how are you doing? You have Mike here, and today we are taking a look at the HM660 by GrowPros. So these guys here all the way from California had reached out and asked me to take a look at their light. So that's what we're gonna do here in this video. So this is actually a pretty unique light. It's a 660 watt light like we just mentioned, but it also has the capability of boosting up to 720. And this is a modular light. So this is something that's a little bit new for the channel. So let's get right into it. This here is using Phillips diodes. There's actually about 3,500 diodes in this light. It's using a mix of 3000K, 5000K, and the 660 nanometer deep red chips that we see. I've also put the spectrum here up on the screen so you can take a look at it. Yeah, it's got a fairly warm color temperature to it. Let's give you guys a little bit of a demo here. Now, you'll see why I don't have the light on all the time, because it's just absolutely blinding. We'll turn it up to 100%, and then up the boost. And I can't see anything. I can now see spots though, so that's good. So for drivers, it is using three Moso 240 watt drivers. So Moso guys, you probably are familiar with them. They're one of the top Chinese brands for making drivers. There's a couple of them, Sosen, Moso, Inventronics, the ones I can think of on top of my head. They're one of the main drivers that are using quite a few lights. So we did kind of just mention the dimmer, so that it can go from 0 to 100% all the way up to the boost feature that we were saying. It also has a EXT mode, which allows it to be connected to the Trollmaster system. So I'm pretty sure you guys are familiar with the Hydro X controller. It's a full environmental control system. It is a fairly costly unit, but it does work with this system here as well. You can control all your lights and dimmers and set timers and all kinds of really cool things with it. So I will leave a link down in the description if you guys would like to take a look at the video from Trollmaster. I just can't use it because I don't have licensing for the footage. So take a look at the link down in the description. So we did mention that this here was a modular light. So I want to talk about that a little bit more. So at the end of each of these bars, we can pull out these plastic clips, which allows us to connect another bar onto it. So that would give us an extra foot on each end, and this would give us either 4x6 coverage, but in all reality, this light here could definitely flower a 5-foot tent. So you probably even buy a 5x6, and maybe even a little bit more. Without having the additional bars though, I don't really want to speculate on that because we haven't been able to test that. So, but I'm pretty sure you'd probably get a little more of it. As you've seen, this light is extremely bright. Okay, so moving on to the daisy chain outlet. I know that a lot of you guys are probably gonna be happy about this because this is one of the most popular comments that I see on pretty much every one of our light videos. So yes, this light here does have a daisy chain outlet, which is really cool. So just as a do note, if you are not using this thing with the Hydro X controller where you're plugging into the data port here into the front, this switch is gonna be turned off, obviously, if you have it on a timer that turns off your light. So it is really cool that it does have a daisy chain, but unless you're using the Hydro X controller, it's not going to be an active daisy chain all the time, right? So something to think about. Now, the warranty of this light is pretty good, so we're going to cover that here. So 1 to 5 years, guys, everything is totally covered. You don't have to pay shipping, you don't have to pay nothing. Actually, that continues all the way on to the 7 years, full 7 years of the warranty. I just wanted to point out, from 1 to 5 years, if you have any issues with your light at all, you let them know. They're just going to give you a brand new light. They're going to replace it, and they're gonna make sure that you're taken care of. It's not gonna cost you anything. They're just gonna send you a brand new light with a return label, and simple as pie. Now, this is also an American company, like I did mention earlier, is from California. So if you have any repairs or anything needs to be done, you're gonna send your light over to California. You're not sending it overseas. You're not sending it to China, and there's not gonna be any language barrier talking to a rep. That is a frustrating experience. I know that a lot of people have expressed that in my videos. So this is something you're not ever going to have to deal with an American company, which is great. So from year 6 to 7, you're still not going to have to pay anything. The company's going to make sure you're fully taken care of, but they're not going to send you a new light. They're going to try to fix the light that you have within there. So the first 5 years, That's absolutely amazing, guys. So that's a pretty great warranty. So once again, this light here was ETO listed. So it's, you know, this light's been properly tested and that it's safe. So it should even be covered under your insurance because it has been ETL marked. But if whether or not your insurance is going to cover what you're doing is a whole different story. So, but anyways. So what we're going to do in testing, it's going to be a little bit different just because it's got the boost feature. So we're going to test the temperatures with it running at 100% and with it running at 120%, if that's what we're going to say, or we just call it the boost up to 720. It kind of makes more sense. So we'll just call it the boost feature and we'll kind of go from there, because if the light is running too hot on boost, there's no point in taking PAR readings and everything else. So beyond that, what we're going to do is going to test the PAR of the light, and then we're going to test the energy consumption coming from the wall. So we got a lot to get into and a lot to cover on this specific light, so let's get into it. Alright guys, so let's take a look at the PAR maps here. We'll start out with the PAR and then we'll go into the temperature and the energy and all that so forth. So we started out in a testing in a reflective environment in a 4x4, and we found out the recommended hang height came out to about 26 inches above the plants. That is pretty high, and this is running at 100% power. So there's some key factors there, 100% power. Running at 655, and do remember that the light can go past 100% into the boost mode. So this was running at the 655 mark. It's the closest I can get it to the 660, and I was doing that with my voltage meter. So when we take a look at it, we're seeing like some pretty even coverage here. Like this is actually pretty phenomenal. 774, 751. 811, 761, and it's really not that far from the 900 that we're seeing in the middle, 950. That's actually pretty impressive coverage. It's in that 26 inches above the 26 inches above the plants. That's phenomenal. I mean, most people that are going to throw this in a tent, they're not going to be using their light on 100%. It's just not needed. 26 inches is just pretty far away. So interesting. We'll take a look at the next mark, which is at 32 inches in reflective. Same wattage, everything else. We just raised the light. 736 on the corners, 739, 682 on the very bottom, 725, and then it just basically stays 700 even. This is the most even coverage on a light I personally have ever seen. This is just amazing coverage. All right, so let's take a look at the other aspect. Now, if we didn't have it in a reflective surface or a tent, we're just trying to use it in an open floor, let's say in an industrial setting. So let's take a look what you would hang it at. So taking a look at the PAR map, it looks like the recommended hang height would probably be around 17 inches. That's where you would want to hang it around. That would work out perfectly for us. So 17 inches, and you can see in the center we hit 1003, But it's usually like nine in the 900s, and then closer to the edges we see 755 and then 550 in the middle, down at the bottom 414 or 412, sorry, 411, 389 and 384. So 17 inches is about where I would hang this. And you still see, since the light is fairly large, you would still get quite a bit of coverage. So looking at the 22 inch mark, this here gives us about hotspot of about 805. So high sevens, very low eights, that 22 inches. So give you guys an idea, fairly decent light. So taking a look at our best PAR map here, that would be the 26 inches would be the recommended hang height. That gives us a 1.94 micromole to watt coming out of this light. So that's pretty decent. So now that we talked about the PAR, I would like to talk about the heat of the light. So what we have done is we let our lights heat up for about 8 hours. And usually by about the 4 hour mark, that is where our lights kind of hit that apogee of heat. That's where it's going to go to the max, and that's about where it stays. So what we have done with this light here is we set it to 100%, pulling 655 watts. And we left it there for 4 hours. We wanted to see how hot it would get. So this is open floor testing like we always do. And the top of the bars came to 50 degrees Celsius. That's 123 Fahrenheit. And the bottom came to 59 degrees Celsius. That's 138 degrees Fahrenheit. So that's not that bad. Now, when we turn up the light to boost, to let's say, you know, the boost feature, I'm not really sure, just let's say boost feature where it's pushing more out of each LED, we definitely did see an increase in temperature. So we had turned it up to boost, we waited another 4 hours. We wanted to see how warm the light would really get running full power. So there you go, on boost. So on the top of the bars, we came to 58 degrees Celsius. On the bottom, 71 degrees Celsius and 159 degrees Fahrenheit. So this is where I'm going to be a little bit critical. That is at the borderline of just being too hot. So I wouldn't run it in boost. I would wait. If you're going to run this light in boost, you should have the additional bars on it. I wouldn't run it 100% if you even need it. Because looking at how powerful this light, even at 27 inches, that's pretty high above your plans for most people, what they would use. So I don't think a lot of people are going to even crank it if they were running this in a tent situation, 4x4 or 5x5. So with it on boost, pushing full boost, it was actually pulling 685 watts. Now, I do believe there is a little bit of loss from it getting, as the light heats up, you are going to lose a little bit of power draw. Just lose a little bit of efficiency. So I believe there is a little bit of loss because when you first start it on, it'll pull 702 watts, but then it drops down to 685 after a little bit of time. So we do know that there is a little bit of loss there, but I do believe that the switches in the back for the additional bars do have some power reserved for that. So that's where the rest of the power, I believe, is gone. That's got some sort of dedicated power to it. So all right, so like I said, this light came back with a 1.94, and I would be really curious to see with this light, with the additional bars, that would make it far more efficient than the 1.9 that we see here. I mean, 1.94 is still really reasonable, but if you had those extra bars with those several hundred more LEDs, it would be something else. So I'd be really interested to see this light with the additional two bars and retest it at that point. I think we'd be getting a lot higher results. I would like to thank you all for watching. If you guys are interested in this light, go check it out, wegrowpros.com. I will put the website link in the description, as well as the video for the Hydro S controller that you guys can use with this, make it all compatible. And yeah, I'm going to leave it here, and you guys all have yourself a great day. Take care.